everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Luna. And Luna is a Yorkshire Terrier who's coming for her full groom today. So I am going to do that and give you a video on that. So we are actually going to be doing a scissor cut on her today. So that just means I do a little bit more work beforehand the bath. And get her all nicely combed out. See, she's got a couple colors going on in there with the dark gray and the light. So what I do first is just get out any tangles. And she does come in quite frequently, so there's not going to be a lot of mats or tangles. But I just like to get those out first. Because that way it'll be a nice, more even of a cut. And we are going to trim up her bum a lot shorter, as the owner likes her bum area short and clean. So I will scissor cut that up more. Not too much gets trimmed off the top of the body. It's more on the sides and underneath and this back area, because that's where the stuff sticks to, as you can see. So I'm not going to worry about getting that out, because I'm going to be trimming this area quite a bit shorter. And you can see she really has a lot of dirt in there of all the stuff sticking. So that is the area that will be going the shortest. And we're going to be doing the shave tips on her ears as well with the clipper blades. That helps them to stay nice and tall and stay upright, and also give them that nice pointy look as well. So if you do like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel. And then you can check out all the other videos I've posted of different dog breeds that I've groomed. And just the different ways that I groom them, and different maneuvers that I've learned over the years. Having my own dog grooming business. You can always let me know if you like or don't like something. But yeah, check it out, subscribe, watch the videos, and let me know what you think. Okay. There's a little bit of resistance here in the paws. You can see there's a little bit of mats in there. Just come up quite easily. Like I said, she does come pretty regularly. There you go. Hard to see with her color of fur. Okay. All right, and there's just on the other leg as well, so not very much, but just enough to have a few mats. And can really see on the inside of her legs that there's a lot of her pee sticks to that area. So I will be doing inside the legs quite a bit shorter just for that reason, because obviously it's sticking in there, which would not be very pleasant for snuggle time. Get that all taken care of. It's very important to get all these kind of combed out, and it just gives her a nice, more even look when I do the scissors. All right. Two little ones there. Okay. So I'll start on this side. Okay, Mimi. And I always go up and down on the legs. I don't want to go crooked or sideways because that would create lines there. If you go up and down, it creates more of a layered look, which is more natural. How the hair naturally lays. And then she does have quite a bit of hair also in her feet, as you can see. I'm going to get all that taken out of there. And her feet are pretty small. You got to go just nice and slow. But I do want to keep some length on there as well. So I'm going to make sure when I trim, I don't go up. I kind of go on an angle. Because you really want to keep, you know, the natural flow of the hair on the top, because you are keeping that hair quite a bit longer. I know. I'm going to trim the inside of the leg quite a bit shorter, just because of where everything is sticking. When I trim in between the toes, I'm not going really high with the scissors. I'm just going just in between them to get that hair out, but leaving the top so that it keeps that length on there. So it kind of blends nicely with the rest of the look of her longer hair. Okay, so I'm just gonna go inside her leg here. Where all the stuff is sticking to. There's a little bit of matting in there as well. Always got to be very careful with the scissors not to poke anything it's not supposed to, or cut anything it's not supposed to. Okay, good girl. Okay, stand up. So now I'm just gonna trim this leg a little bit shorter and under the belly a little bit. It's nice to always get them kind of standing in their natural stance if possible. She's kind of being a little awkward. Not sure what to do, eh? She's a good girl. Yeah, good girl. So again, just scissoring up and down, Again, not taking too much off, but cleaning it up really nice. This one, I'll see if I can get you a better view of what the bottom of the pad looks like. Okay. 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 Still gotta go back and trim those nails on the back. And when I finish this one, I'll go back and trim those. There we go. All right, so now I'm going to work on her face and kind of like her chest area, just kind of this area here. So again, I'm going to just scissor cut low downwards. So again, it kind of gives it that layered look. Just going to make sure it's spread out good. One right there. I'm just gonna get to layer a little bit better. There we go. Okay, and now, so I'm just gonna start around her eyes first. All right, we're gonna leave a nice little just the trim, but still leave it quite long. Again, so it blends with the rest of the body. I'm gonna layer the muzzle. But she's got quite a bit of tearing in there, so it's a little bit wet. And as it dries here, we'll be able to kind of blend it as well. And just kind of have a nice long layer on the face. And I can always trim it shorter when the owner comes, but I do like to err on the side of caution and just leave it a little bit longer. And then if the owner prefers it a little bit shorter, I can always trim it real quick while they're waiting. Ears are actually a little bit inflamed, and they do look like they have a type of yeast infection or bacteria infection. So I'll get the hair out of there and just make sure that the owner know maybe you need to make a trip to the vet. And how that's noted, or how you can tell that, I don't know if I'll be able to get in enough, but the ears are reddish pinkish there, but they got little bumps on them, and so they're a little bit inflamed. Here, I'll give you this one as well. This one's not as pink, but it's a little bit swollen, but you might be able to see there. Just a little bit swollen, you can tell by those in there, and of course a little irritated, but a little bit swollen. And usually you can see some scratch marks as well from them scratching. So I'm going to take that hair out, and that will help, but they will still need to go see a vet. Once it's in there, you can't get rid of it without the medication. So we'll take this hair out. And of course, when you're doing this, the ears will be a little bit more sensitive. You just gotta be careful and go slow. And they might have a smell to them. Okay. There we go. And so we got all the hair out. There wasn't much in there. These on the side so I can wash them. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to switch over to this side now. We'll start with the front leg. Get that towel. Come on. She just squirms away just enough. Okay. Okay. One left. Alright, so the last leg here, I'll do a little bit under, well actually here the front of this leg as well. Go. Okay, so just the underbelly a little bit. So I'm just gonna go inside the inner leg again. There we go. Okay, I'm just gonna work on this bum area where the owner does like it quite a bit shorter. I'm just gonna see where everything is at. I'm gonna trim the tail so it doesn't hang into that area, but you can see, yeah, there's lots of stuff stuck in here. Could still make it nice and short, but even with the scissors, but just kind of want to blend it with the rest of the body there. Okay, let go. There we go. All right. I'm just going to layer out the top of the ears here. And then get the number 10 clipper blade, and then I'm going to shave those tips. Finish the ears just by trimming where I shaved really close so that it will give it that nice distinct pointed look. And there we go, and there's some pointed shaved tips, which I don't do too often, so definitely nice to get it on video here for you. All right, so there we go. So I'm going to get them into the tub now. Okay. All right, so I'll give them a good rinse off. Water off. Okay, there you go. we'll get her back to the table. Give her a blow dry. Getting ready for the blow dry. To lay how it naturally lays, so kind of however she shakes it out, then I can kind of see like those ones that I'll kind of trim off a little bit, just so it'll lay a little flatter, and then just layer it out, and then on the side of the legs, you can kind of see where some sticks out a little bit. I'll do those as well. Okay. Hey. second blow dry, I'm gonna try to keep take her head thing off so that I can kind of blow dry her face as well a little bit. There we go. Just kind of want to blend them so they look even. Okay. All right, so I'm just going to give her another quick blow dry, and this time I'm not going to use the head scarf. See how her face is gonna lay. I just kind of blend everything together and layer it. There we go. So there is Luna's haircut. So hopefully you enjoyed it. A little demonstration of more of a scissor cut on a little Yorkshire Terrier. So thanks for taking the time to watch. I hope you enjoyed the video and hope you'll check out my channel and subscribe to it. And let me know if you'd like to see something different. So thanks again and I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.